Today, I'm going to review Dracula, the 1958 version. Previously, I reviewed the 1931 version. That was the one with Bella. That was my very first film review. So this time, I'm doing the 58 version with Christopher Lee. This was Hammer's very first Dracula film, and it's directed by Terence Fisher, who's their best director. And this film's actually classed as Hammer's best film. I won't go as far as that, because there's good points and bad points about this film that I'll discuss later in the review. But this is classed as their masterpiece. And a lot of critics say it's their one of the best horror films ever made. It tops the list of many film reviews that always put Dracula, and it tends to be near the top when they do lists of horror films. It's only 82 minutes long. It only cost £81,000 to make, although that was 1958. However, it made £3.5 million worldwide, so a massive success. It has Christopher Lee playing Dracula and also Peter Cushing playing Van Helsing. Both excellent in this film. There's also a few interesting things about this film. Dracula can't turn into a bat. Dracula having red eyes, red contact lenses that Christopher Lee put in, and fangs. He didn't say any of that in the earlier films. It must have scared the hell out of people in 1958. Audiences would only have been watching like the Universal films, one or two colour films, but nothing kind of graphic or anything. But this film, it must have really shook folk up. I can't imagine what they were like when the first, say, Christopher Lee, when he bursts in with his red eyes and his fangs with blood dripping off them. That must have startled a few people, that. This is the Blu-ray that I watched it on, and it's good because there's two versions. There's like the normal version that's restored, but also you get the version that's got extra footage, so you see more horror, like the disintegration of Dracula. You see more of it. You see his hand doing that while he's turning into ashes.
Hey, does Dracula turn into fucking me at the end?
So it's really good, and also the apart from the extra footage, because you can say the picture quality kind of changes when you say the uncut footage. Where the normal footage, it's crystal clear for a 1958 film. Really good Blu-ray if you wanna get that. That's the one to get. It's interesting because with this film, you can tell like Christopher Lee is a lot younger than the other Dracula films that he does later, because there was a big break between this and his next film, the 7-year break. So in this film, he's like younger and fitter, and he's more energetic, does a lot of running around, and he actually looks a lot more scarier somehow with him being younger looking. He also has a lot of dialogue at the beginning of the film when he's talking to Jonathan Harker. Unfortunately, after that, he doesn't utter a word, just hisses. So that's a shame, but at least he has a lot of dialogue at the beginning. Obviously, with it being a Hammer film, the sets and the costumes are all good. The music's interesting, it's nice and loud. I also like the staking scene, it's excellent. Jonathan Harker, he finds Dracula and the vampire lady, and he kills the female vampire. Instead of killing Dracula first, he kills her, stakes her. But there's a great scene where, after he stakes her, the camera shoots on the coffin, and inside the coffin, it's an old hag. So this beautiful young woman turns into this old woman. Really effective, that. I think that's probably my favourite scene in the film. I like all the cross-burning effects as well. Scenes where Peter Cushing puts a cross on this woman's forehead, takes it off, and you see the cross burn. It's also palm of the hand as well, a little crucifix burn mark. And the ending's excellent, where Dracula gets killed by light. Peter Cushing jumps and pulls the curtain down, and the sunlight disintegrates Dracula. And you see, like, more extended footage of it, because the Blu-ray has got the uncut version. It looks excellent. That's one of the best Dracula deaths. Now on to the bad points. The trouble with this film is, when I first watched it, it was overhyped. So I was expecting too much when I first watched it. But over the years, each time I watch it, it gets a little bit better, a little bit better. It's a bit similar to the very first James Bond film, Dr. No. When I first watched that, I thought it was crap. But now I really like it. Because that was overhyped. A lot of fans say it's the best James Bond film. Which it isn't. I don't think it is. But I still really like it. This is similar. A lot of fans say this is definitely the best Hammer Dracula. And I disagree with that. But over the years, I like it a little bit more each time I watch it. I've always wondered why I didn't like it as much as I should. And recently when I watched it this time, it suddenly occurred to us, I know why. It's bloody Michael Gough. He's crap. His personality is too boring. He's miscast. They should have had like a laden young man playing the part, but they got him. And he's like hammy as well.
He makes me bloody hungry wanting a ham sandwich. Bloody hammy bastard.
He's so boring in the scenes. Like, all the scenes that involve him are the worst parts of the film. He's good when he's playing villains. He's like, for instance, when he plays a celestial toy maker in Doctor Who, he's good. In other horror films and stuff, he's good as a villain. But as a, like, a normal hero type of fella, he's miscast. And he makes us tired just watching him. You know, there's not much life in him. He's like bloody undead, isn't he?
Mina, you gave me quite a fright. Where have you been at this hour?
Such a lovely day. I got up early and went for a walk in the garden. I didn't expect you back so soon.
I'm afraid I've got to go out again.
Oh. When will you be back?
I can't say for sure. Mina, you look pale. Are you all right?
Arthur, darling, don't fuss. I feel perfectly well. Goodbye, darling.
Hey, that bloody Michael, bloody Gough. Puts me to bloody sleep, the bloody useless bugger.
I really like the other Dracula films a heck of a lot, so I'm like comparing it. I did a review of The Satanic Rites of Dracula, and that's that and Dracula Has Risen from the Grave are my two favourite Hammer Dracula films. So this one, it's pale compared to them, but I do like it. It's still a good film. They reckon it's kind of a bit fearful to the novelisation. But I think the novel's crap anyway, so I'm not bothered about that. There's good direction. I like the very first shot, where you see this statue outside the castle. Then you go inside this crypt, and you see Dracula's coffin, and then the symbolic blood dripping onto the coffin lid. That's pretty good. It is a good film. It's good, but not one of my favourites, though. So out of 10. If it wasn't for Michael Gough, I would give it 9 out of 10, but he drops it down a lot. So I'll give it 8. I'm going to be generous. I'll give it 8 out of 10. It is a landmark film. But I don't think Gaunt's a deal like it.
I give the bugger top marks. Phil's bloody hard to please.
You cheeky bugger bones. Anyway, bye everyone. Bye.